Dear students, in the last class we have seen how to use F-test to test this overall significance of an estimated regression line. Now, for practical applications, it is easy if we recast F in terms of R square. Stated differently, we can formulate F test statistics in terms of R square, the multiple coefficient of determination, by using the relationship between these two. Let us see how. We consider the general k variable model, that is yi sum of beta 1 plus beta 2 x2y plus etc. beta k xki plus ui. The null hypothesis is that beta 2 is equal to beta 3 is equal to beta k is equal to 0. Remember this, when we test the overall significance, the intercept is not included. Our aim is to find out whether y is related to the explanatory variables or not. Then F is equal to, given this hypothesis, F is equal to ESS by K minus 1 divided by RSS by N minus K. This quantity follows F with the K minus 1 degrees of freedom in the numerator and N minus K degrees of freedom in the denominator. This is the F test statistics. Now, let us see how we manipulate F to specify F in terms of R square. Now, F is equal to ESS by K minus 1 divided by RSS by N minus K equal to ESS by K minus 1 into N minus K by RSS, or N minus K by K minus 1 into ESS by RSS equal to N minus K by K minus 1 into ESS by RSS is TSS minus ESS. RSS is TSS minus ESS is equal to N minus K by K minus 1 into ESS by TSS divided by TSS minus ESS by TSS is equal to N minus K by K minus 1 into ESS by TSS is R square divided by 1 minus TSS by TSS by 1 minus ESS by 1 minus ESS by TSS, again R square. So we write F as equal to R square by K minus 1 divided by 1 minus R square by N minus K. Remember this formula. For the general K variable model, F in terms of R square is, F is equal to R square by K minus 1 divided by 1 minus R square by N minus K. If it is a two variable model, it is R square by 1 by 1 minus r square by n minus 2. 3 variable model r square by 2 divided by 1 minus r square by n minus 3. Like that. So if we present f in terms of r square, we need not calculate all these quantities, ESS, RSS, etc. We need to know only r square. Then f can easily be constructed. And let us see what is the relation between f and r square. As you can see from the formula, f and r square are directly related. For example, if r square is equal to 0, then f is also equal to 0. 0 here, r square 0 means f is also equal to 0. If r square is equal to 1, then f is equal to infinity. If r square is equal to 1, 0 here, then f is equal to infinity. And higher the value of r square, in general, higher the value of r square, higher will be the value of f. R square and f are directly related. So if you have a k-variable model, you can always specify n f in terms of r square. Remember this formula and also remember this relationship. What is r square? R square measures the proportion of the variation in y explained jointly by all the explanatory variables. What is f? F measures whether all these variables are simultaneously equal to 0 or not. R square high means jointly x2, x3, etc., xk explain significant proportion of the variation in y. So high R square means not all these variables are simultaneously equal to 0. So high R square means f is also high. R square 1 means f is infinity. High R square, high f. Low R square then means low f also. So remember this important relationship between R square and f. And we will use this again and again. So the procedure is, again, we recast f in terms of R square. And if f exceeds f alpha for the given sample size and chosen level of significance, we reject H0, that beta 2 is equal to beta 3 is equal to etc. beta k is equal to 0. This is the relationship between f and r square in the general k variable model, and this is applicable to two variable model, three variable model, or a general k variable model.